Okay, guys, so we're just about to walk away, and the redneck keelback just went for and predated on its favorite meal, the common Asian toad. This is a live predation, so we're going to film it as long as we can. And this is super interesting because if you remember from previous videos, the redneck keelback actually sequesters poison from the toads that it eats, that it can then excrete through glands on its neck. And the redneck keelback is also significantly venomous. And if you pay attention to what's going on here, you can see the keelback is actually chewing with its back teeth on the toad. So this is how it actually injects its poison. It doesn't have normal fangs like a venomous snake, like a cobra or a viper. It actually has grooved teeth in the back that it uses to drip the venom into its prey. So it's chewing right now so that it can actually drip the venom in. We've got a plane flying over, but I'm not going to stop the video. This is, like I said, a live predation, so this is not very common to see from start to finish like this. He literally just shot into that weep hole and grabbed this toad and yanked him out. So we're going to follow this predation through. You can see there the redneck keelback is using its rear fangs to chew its venom into the toad. You can see the rear fang there. The rear fang right there as it opens its mouth to gnaw. And it's amazing how when so many of these snakes start to predate, how they really can't be bothered. We're actually in relatively close proximity watching this happen. And the snake really isn't very bothered by our presence. He's really focused on getting his meal in. You can hear that the toad is actually puffed up, but as the snake's biting, you can hear air coming out of the toad. Try and give you guys as best an angle as we can so that you can see the fangs and you can see the behavior of the keelback as it eats the toad. You can see he's got a pretty good grip on him now. He's working the back legs in. Toad seems to be slowing down quite a bit. I'm not sure if this is a result of the venom from the keelback, but you can see there's a black substance coming out of the toad's mouth. And looks like it's, I can't tell if it's dripping or if it's just popping out on the sides of the toad, but it's a black coloration here, you can see. Very, very intense. Amazing to be able to observe this. I know it's not going to be to everyone's taste to see something quite this dramatic, but this is nature at work. And this is a pretty great example of a dynamic situation. As I mentioned, this is exactly how these redneck keelbacks sequester the poison that they use for self-defense. And you can see the venom and anticoagulants in the saliva and in the venom at work as well. The there's quite a bit of blood coming from the toad now as a result. Actually a relatively large prey at him while it's still puffed up, so it'll be interesting to see how the keelback works it down. You can see here the focus still seems to be, looks like he's trying to work it down a bit, but really he seems to be working pretty hard to get those rear fangs in. Interesting that given how toxic the venom is said to be in these guys, the toad is still taking quite a while to succumb to the venom, so very interesting to see how it plays out. process from start to finish, about just shy of 14 minutes. And the redneck still has a couple of pushes, I think, to get it down so that it can get a little bit more air. But that is all it takes. Redneck keelback predating on a common Asian toad. So we're gonna just watch for another minute or so, and then we're gonna let this redneck get to digesting his meal. Very exciting observation. Right, I think we're gonna log off now and give this guy some space to finish digesting. All right, off to see what's next.